Time now for us to go viral. Check out comedian Dave Chappelle getting some shots at Lakers practice yesterday. Thankfully, his comedy is better.
Oh, he nailed that one, though.
Than his earlier jump shot.
But the setup
is not great for him. It's not great for him. He's got a little Rondo to him. But he's getting it there. Hey, man, a lot of folks go to these NBA practices and try to line up from the NBA three-point range and come 4 feet short.
Yes, it is a drastic difference from shooting a high school or collegiate three-point shot.
What do you mean a lot of? You can just go to a Lakers practice?
A lot of famous people.
Well, that's what's going to get in the way of them focusing
on
the practice.
Dave Chappelle can do it. Dave Chappelle left his ranch home in, I think, the state of Ohio outside of Cincinnati, went to L.A., had a nice little weekend. Good for him.
If any famous people want to come watch us work here, you can just
Dave Chappelle, Jenna, you know what you would like to love about Dave Chappelle?
It's his stand-up.
Okay, sure, but more particularly just to you.
Yeah.
When Dave Chappelle burst onto the scene, very, very skinny guy, skinnier than me, and then became a bit of a workout warrior, bulked up about 40 pounds. It looks like maybe he's not toning the way he once was.
He's trending in a slightly different direction.
I mean, he became sabbatical after Chappelle's show. Came son of a workout freak. I thought it'd be something you'd do.
It is, and anyone can do it, Nick.
Absolutely.
Spend some time with me. Time for stories to start your morning. Last night, Phillip Rivers struggled taking care of the ball in that loss to the Kansas City Chiefs. Rivers throwing four picks, adding another one. It was dropped by Tyrann Mathieu, almost added another one there. Nick, what'd you make of Rivers' performance last night?
He's cooked. In fact, he's overdone. He's a steak that's been left on the grill for far too long. Hey, man, that class of 04 quarterbacks, it's over. And folks in Pittsburgh about to figure out that it's over when Big Ben comes back. Eli's done. Big Ben's elbow popped, and Phillip Rivers is donezo. Seven picks in his last two games. Like you mentioned, Jenna, could have had a fifth. Tyrann Mathieu just dropped it. And Phillip Rivers had a really, really good career. It's going to be an interesting Hall of Fame case. But I fear for the Chargers, they're going to try to deny that he's done and trot him back out there next season, which will really delay their ability to become the team they should become, especially once Derwin James comes back.
Yeah, that's my concern. You have to know when to move on, and I get it. Phillip Rivers, statistically, he's always been in the upper echelon of quarterback passers in our National Football League. However, he's always averaged about 13 interceptions per season since he's taken over in 2006, and you have to know when to move on. It's time. They have not won with him for 16 years, so you have to move on now. Guys.
Credit to them, by the way. They didn't give him the contract extension this offseason, so this is the last year of his deal. If they want to move on, they can. I don't know if they will.
All right, after another stellar performance, Lamar Jackson has officially moved past Russell Wilson as the betting favorite for MVP. Lamar has 788 rushing yards on the season, the most by a quarterback through 10 games in the Super Bowl era. Nick, you think Lamar should be the MVP favorite?
Right now, the MVP favorite conversation is this right here. Let me do it. Who you got, heads or tails? Heads is Russ, tails is Lamar Jackson. It's that close. It's as close as it. You know what? Very similar to last year, where at this point in the season, it was a coin flip between Mahomes and Breeze. And then Mahomes continued his excellence. Breeze, the final quarter of the season, fell off. Right now, Lamar and Russell have distinguished themselves above everyone else. I would, if I had a vote, which I don't, right now I'd vote for Russell. But Lamar is trending in such a positive direction. He's a couple more strong weeks from truly overtaking Russell Wilson, at least in my eyes. But right now, Greg, it's a two-person race.
Yeah, when you look at what Lamar Jackson has been able to do, it's been superb, as well as Russell Wilson. I would just go on the side of leaning towards Lamar Jackson simply for these reasons. When you play the Baltimore Ravens, you understand that you have to stop Lamar Jackson. You cannot stop Lamar Jackson, either throwing the ball or running the ball. And so when I look at that, understanding this league, and it is a defensive stop, pass stopper league, and you can't do either when you're playing against the Baltimore Ravens because of how special and uniquely gifted this young man is, that's an MVP.
All right, let's move on to the NBA, where Luka Doncic put on a show against the Spurs. It's all he's been doing this season. Last night, dropped 42 points, 11 rebounds, 12 assists, becoming the second youngest player in NBA history to record a 40-point triple-double. Behind only Nick.
LeBron James.
LeBron James. So why don't you tell us, Nick, how great was Luka last night?
Oh, my large adult Slovenian son continues to just amaze. It is going to be, aside from watching my children grow up, the thing I am the most excited for over the next decade is watching Luka from Slovenia and Giannis, a Nigerian kid from Greece, take over the NBA and just battle it back and forth between Milwaukee and Dallas. Luka does everything well. And if he never improves, he's 20 years old, if he never improves 1%, he's a Hall of Famer. If he could just maintain this level for a decade and he's going to improve, I can't believe the Mavs are going to go 30 uninterrupted years from Dirk to Luka, and they did it through having the fifth pick of the draft when he was available.
Yeah, that's what's been most impressive for me, his ability to just take the torch and just run with it and even set it even more on fire and ablaze. What I like about Luka Doncic that nobody tends to really talk about is his killer mentality. Ooh. Like, he, in the clutch moments, we talk about stars rising to the occasion. Get me the ball, I will make a play for us, and I will get it done. He has ice in his veins, he's fearless, and he makes it happen on the court, night in and night out.
It was a two-point game when he hit that three to give him above 40 points for the night. It iced the game.
That win, 444 passing yards, while Ezekiel Elliott once again took second fiddle. Hey, Dak is first in the NFL in passing yards. Zeke is eighth in rushing yards. Yesterday, on Undisputed, Hall of Fame running back LaDainian Tomlinson was asked what he thought about Zeke's lack of production.
Anytime you have a young quarterback, you got a young offense coordinator, you're going to want to try to uplift that young quarterback to be in the MVP race, right?
Okay.
And so naturally, you're not going to run the ball as much as you used to. You want to use all those weapons. They have massive weapons at the wide receiver position. Gallup has stepped up. Randall Cobb has stepped up. I love their receiving core.
That's a hot take right there. Nick, you worried Zeke doesn't get back on track this season, back to Zeke standards?
No. Such prisoners of the moment. Zeke, as of, take away the last two games, his three games prior, he had 355 yards rushing and was averaging 5 yards per carry. Like, he was up until, he's had a bad 2 weeks. And evidently, you're not allowed that in the NFL anymore. Like, bad 2 weeks, oh, he's washed, he's cooked, forget about it. And it should be noted, I believe part of Dak's success this season is defenses are still, now maybe they'll adjust because Dak's played at such a high level. They are still worried about stopping 21 first and foremost, which is opening things up for Dak.
Yeah.
And because Dak has played at such a high level and the passing game's been so effective, I wonder if teams now are going to have to start to adjust the other way, remove one of those defenders from the box to start giving help on the outside on either Cooper or Gallup, help on the inside to Cobb, and then you'll see Zeke eating again. I don't think Zeke all of a sudden, between the middle of October and Halloween, lost his ability. I just think he's had a bad two football games that right now we want to assign it as, oh, is he not worth the money? Is he over the hill at year four? When everything we had seen from Zeke prior to two games ago yelled, he's one of the three best people in the world at what he does.
Yeah, I'm with you. He'll get right back to where we've seen him in years prior and years past. What I don't like, and I respect LaDainian Tomlinson, I don't agree with at all that Kellen Moore and this staff is trying to promote Dak Prescott to MVP status. No. What they're doing is utilizing what has been working. But defenses, to your point, their number one responsibility in all of football is to stop the run. When you get into a defensive unit meeting and you hear a defensive coordinator start their conversation, men, we got to stop the run. We are going to make them one-dimensional. And what the Cowboys have always been able to do is run the football. And so it's going to be a challenge from night in to night out, from Sunday to Sunday, every time Ezekiel Elliott is in that backfield to run the ball. But when you look at last year through 10 games, he had 194 attempts.
Bless you.
He had 191 attempts, 953 yards. This year, 194 attempts, 833 yards, 7 touchdowns. So he's right where he was last year, and he rushed for 1,400 yards. He'll
coming
be okay.
into the season, it was probably always, oh, let's let Dak beat us. Well, Dak's starting to beat you now, and now so you're going to have to give him a little bit. Exactly. All right, take a break. Coming up, should Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs be concerned after barely